different because I feel like this team is just is completely different. The mentality has really changed. We know what our goal is. We've been paying attention to detail and focusing on what we need to do in order to get to a national championship.
How much difference do you notice in how I miss you she's going into your second? Was there a different way she's going about things that you noticed?
Holly is more into us enjoying the game, making sure we are doing the little things. When we do the little things, things turn out better for us. The intensity of practice, I mean, she's picked it up a lot this year because she knows the capabilities that we have when we get into the national championship.
Do you think she's more comfortable as the head coach this year than last year?
I think so, and I think there's a little bit more pressure off of her because she knows that last year, you know, we're in the position that we were in, getting to the Elite Eight that nobody thought that we would get into. She's been able to keep that in the back of her mind and know what she's capable of as a coach and depend on us as players to get to the next level.
Last year you guys were fourth and fifth to start the season, depending which pool you're in. This year, back to that top spot. Do you guys like being in that top spot? Do you like that expectation?
I feel like any position that we're in, we just have to play the game of basketball and let everybody know and represent the University of Tennessee no matter what. So I think we go out there and play our game and play how Tennessee plays. I think everything would be perfectly fine.
What about that post you guys have now? It has to be one of the best post groups in the nation, without doubt. What do you think of what you guys have down low?
I think it's amazing. I feel like, you know, the time is now for us to get to a national championship. We have all the pieces to the puzzle. We just have to put it all together and stick together no matter what throughout the season, no matter what ups and downs we have, and just continue to move forward and continue to work hard every day in practice.
Megan, I'm from Chattanooga. It didn't start so well last year down there. What were you thinking walking off the court that night? I mean, were you worried, or did you all just think it was one bad night?
I think it was just one bad night. I wasn't worried. It was really just a test to see where we were mentally. No matter what competition that we have to play against, we have to be able to play Tennessee basketball. But I knew that there was something greater for us, greater for us in store for the rest of the year. So I knew it was just a test to see where we would be if we were in that situation again. So I think we handled it pretty well.
You all had Georgia Tech on.
What impressed you about that? Because there was obviously a lot of pressure on Holly at that point. What impressed you about how Holly handled those 48 hours in there?
Holly was just calm. She expected great things of us at the beginning of the year. And we knew what we had to do in order to get better. She forced us to become better players and pay attention to detail. Like I said, she's very calm about it, but in practice she was very intense. She knew what we had to do in order to change our mentality and change our mindset. So, and that's what we did. From those 48 hours, we worked hard and we did the best that we could to pay attention to detail and learn from the mistakes that we had to get.
In some ways, was it maybe a good thing to lose that game to kind of then just focus on basketball?
In the beginning, you know, sometimes you hate to lose the first game. But like I said, it was just a test to see where we would be later on in the season. And we got a lot further than a lot of people thought. So I was very happy. I was very pleased with how well we ended the season last year as an underdog. So I think, you know, there's even greater things to come this year as well. You know, good for them to follow, be a leader by example, try to build them up when they're down. Just kind of like my teammates did as I grew up.
Tennessee had to rely on a lot of youngsters last year, and it's in another impressive class that joins the team this year. Mm-hmm. What do you think of the newcomers?
They're amazing. They're these two players who I consider solid. Like, Mercedes is very quiet, but you never know what you're going to get from her. She's just one of those good players. And Jordan, she's just one of these players that you, like I said, you don't like with Mercedes. You never know what you're going to get from her. And I know know that they're going to bring a lot to the table. They know their roles. They know what they need to do. They're on the floor. They've got some things to learn, but I know they're going to be quick learners, and I know they're going to feel ready for the rest of the season.
He also had some teammates that went through injury last year. How are they doing and coming back and getting ready to contribute this year?
Izzy, I'm excited. Izzy's fully recovered. Dre is also fully recovered, so I'm excited to see, you know, how well Dre comes out and, you know, having that uptick on game when she gets back out on the floor. So I'm just excited for everybody, you know, from the people who were injured last year, for Nia, who didn't get to play as much, but for everybody.
Last year you win an SEC championship the regular season. What was it like to do that with Coach Holly in her first full year as Tennessee's head coach?
It was an amazing feeling. I just got on my knee and I cried because the underdog mentality was still there, but I was happy at the fact that we achieved something that proved everyone wrong. The naysayers were, you know, saying that, you know, well, Tennessee's this number, so they're not going to do much. But when we got out there on the floor, we left everything out there on the floor. And I think that I was very pleased with that. I knew that, you know, like I said to somebody else here, that, you know, I knew that there was greater things to come. So I think that was a great thing to know that we won that.
Despite the turnover, despite the adversity and the injury, you guys are right there on the cusp of the Final Four, only to come up just short. How much has that fueled this offseason?
It really has fueled this offseason a lot. I mean, it's made us more hungry. You know, in the summer, we all stayed the whole summer. We wanted to work hard. We wanted to make ourselves better individually in order to make ourselves better as a team cohesively. So I think that it's going to be a great season this year. I just can't wait to see the fruits of the labor that we've put in so far in the summer and in the preseason. So I'm really excited.
What have you been working on?
Me, I've really just been working on the little things as far as my handles, paying attention to detail on my shot, moving my feet, my footwork on defense, and things like that. So I think this year, just me paying attention to the details is really going to help me this year.
What does it mean to you to be named the preseason conference player of the year?
It means a lot, but you never know what's going to happen. So I really don't pay attention to it. But, I mean, I just say, you know, God, I thank you for, you know, allowing me for other people to see what I'm capable of. But then at the same time, I just be patient. I don't get big-headed about it. I just become grateful for it and just continue to work hard.
Do you have team goals, or is that with Tennessee, is that always the top?
National championship is our team goal. Yes, sir.
The fact that Tennessee has been a while since it's won a national championship, are the players ready to enter that challenge?
We are. There's no doubt in my mind. I mean, the university is behind us. Our friends and family are behind us. We know what we need to do to get there. And I think with that, we do those little things to get there, and we will be perfect.
Thank you so much.
You're
good
welcome.
Luck this year.
Thank you. It's just a great experience. I'm blessed to have this opportunity.
Great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Meighan, how did your relationship with Holly, if at all, have to change your relationship with her assistant? My perception of her as an assistant, I don't know, I appreciate it. More good cop, maybe somebody you could go to, confide in. And as a head coach, that's probably not the same role. I mean, how did it have to change for you personally?
Honestly, it really didn't change. I mean, I feel like Holly, you know, Holly was just one of those coaches who wanted the best for everybody. But it wasn't a good cop, bad cop. She was just one of those coaches who knew what we wanted as players. She knows as a player, for playing under Pat, she knew what to expect as a player. So we came to her for anything, whether it be good, whether it be bad. But I think with me being, even as my position coach, I knew that I was still going to have that relationship. And as a head coach, it just became even stronger for me. So I don't think that wasn't really any change.
So you didn't feel like there was really any change there?
I thought it was, for me, I thought it was more of a beneficial change rather than any negativity, any negative type change. So I think it was just an even better thing to know that she was the head of all positions and of everything that we had.
If you step back from your relationship with her and look at her now, how much different is she now as a head coach than maybe she was when you first, in the role she's in now, when you first came from as a coach?
Being CEO of a team, you run everything. So I think, you know, with Holly as an assistant to Pat, she was one of those coaches that Pat could depend on at any point in time. But Holly now is her own boss. So if there's something that she doesn't like, she has that opportunity or that role to actually say, you know, I don't like this. This is something that I'm going to change. But as an assistant, you have to listen to your CEO. You're an assistant for a reason. But right now, she has her own assistants that are there for her. And she's just going to continue to be the head of the snake.
Was there a point last year where this was driven home, and she's the head honcho? Now, I'm thinking maybe that was after that Stanford game. Mm-hmm. She went on the warpath for a couple of weeks. She changed the starting lineup for the Davidson game. Was that a point in time where it was really driven home to you? Yeah, she's in charge of the office. Is there something else, another instance you can remember?
I really couldn't feel any different whether or not, you know, I knew that she was going to be the head coach. I just knew that she was a coach. That's what I knew. I knew that she was just one of the coaches that had to be there, that had to step up in that position. So I just felt like there wasn't any change. I just felt like she was just another coach that needed to know her role and step up at any point in time, just like the players do.
Meighan, she's brought up a couple of times over there about kind of now leaning on quality more than quantity. Practice time, and she kind of credited y'all with that. Can you talk about that?
And like I said to you earlier, we pay attention more to detail, and that's what she meant when she said quality over quantity. And I think it's so much on how much time we spend on a certain drill or how much time we spend on a certain detail, but the detail that we pay attention to. And I think that that's one of the things that we really focus on this year. And when we focus on the little things and the details, I think the quantity will come after that. That'll show everything else and how much time
we spend. But if practice has been a little shorter?
No. Practices have still been the same, no matter what.
Not less hard than before.
No, it remains the same.
But is she concentrating on specific detail things then?
Right now, I think she's focusing more on making better passes, finding the open man, moving our feet on defense, making sure, because the rules have changed with fouling and things like that, details like that, not touching, giving them enough room, just like I said, paying attention to everything when it comes to the game of basketball, making the easy shots, easy layups, things like that.
She said you've been much more in tune to defense. Can you address that?
Since Pat has challenged me with defense, I think that has become more of my mentality, because I know when I focus on defense, it's everything else falls into place. So I think this year is going to be even better, because my defense really has changed. A lot of people don't know that over the summer, that was one of the biggest things that I worked on, was working on my footwork, cutting people off, keeping my man in the basket in between me. So I think it's going to be a great thing to see.
And she talked a lot about y'all being on campuses. I assume this was different than other summers.
It really has. With Holly being completely the head right now, I think, you know, with some of the changes that she's made, it has benefited us a lot more, because it's caused us to create a stronger chemistry, be more cohesive out on the floor, and off the floor. We don't have to be together all the time, but we know something new about each and every player on the team. So I think that's a great thing that she's done that. It keeps us together. It, you know, it doesn't make us, you know, feel as if we're just individuals on a team, but we're a team.
Meighan, how did this come about? I mean, when did she meet with y'all to stay on campus in the summer?
I knew that early on, after the last season, I knew she wanted us. She knew who was coming in, so she wanted us to be together and not feel as individuals. So she just brought us in and told us, you know what, this is what I want. And as a team, as to us getting where we want to go, we have to be together as a team. And she made that decision. So I respected her decision as a senior and as a player for her. So I think it was a great thing that she did for us to keep us together.
So how much of the summer did you spend?
Awesome. I was there awesome.
And in a different year, how much would you have not been?
Oh, I was on campus all summer. Every summer.
Every summer.
I've been in school every summer. So it was. It hasn't been any different for me because I've been in school every single summer.
Then for the team as a whole, how different was it? I mean, how many, what percentage of players would typically have stayed in the summer as opposed to this summer?
Everybody, really. I think just everybody. Everybody was, I would have to say, people wanted to be here in the summer to make themselves better. So
this summer?
Yeah, this summer.
But I mean, in the past summers, in the other summers, what percentage of the team would have stuck around?
I feel like about 80%, 80-85% of the team stayed around. Some people went home, but this year, everybody stayed the entire summer.
It's kind of cliche to ask Lady Vols about expectations. High, because they're always high, but how are y'all, she kind of says y'all embrace those because that's what they recruit to, the players. Is that comfortable position for y'all?
I think it really is very comfortable for us because, like you said, expectations are always high. And with those expectations comes a lot of responsibility. There's a reputation to uphold. And I think with that, I think we've taken that as a way to make us build ourselves as players and as women. And it makes us stronger. So mentally and physically. So I think with that, we take those expectations and use them to the best of our abilities to make us better players.
And with teams like Kentucky, if that have gotten so good in the last few years, you guys kind of have to stay on your toes. There's no getting too comfortable in SEC, is there?
Oh, there's, because you never know what's going to happen, you know, as far as like the players and everything and the teams that, you know, that come out and play. So I think it's just going to be a great thing. You know, like I said, you never know who's going to come out or what team is going to come out and play hard. So it's just going to be a good thing to see what happens.